Welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Roxanne the Tiny Taster, and today's video is not a recipe. It's actually really, really special because today is Navroz. So Navroz Mubarak to all you wonderful people. Now I know a lot of you don't know what Navroz is. It is actually the Irani New Year or the Persian New Year. It marks the onset of spring on spring equinox, and it is celebrated with much pomp and splendor by the Irani community, the Irani Zoroastrian community in Iran, all over the world actually. It's amazing how many people celebrate Navroz. But I wanted to show you how we celebrate it over here, the Irani Zoroastrians, the Zoroastrian community. Even the Parsis like to celebrate it the same way. And I just think it's so special because, you know, we lay out this elaborate table and it's just so beautiful. So I'm going to show that to you. I'm actually going to go over to my neighbor's house. She lays out this beautiful table every year, and I'll have her sort of talk you through it just to get a little bit more information and understand how the festival is celebrated. So this is my lovely neighbor, Katie. Navroz Mubarak, thank you so much. And I'm going to greet you traditionally. I was told we always give a rose when we come to someone's house for Navroz. So that's my rose for you.
Thank you so much, Roxanne. So I put the rose in the water.
Lovely.
And usually we in turn take the rose when we go to someone else's house. And this is how we greet you. You have to look in the mirror, and I will sprinkle some
rose water. Okay, so you're going to
put it on your
face. So I sprinkle the rose water, and then
apply gently on your face.
So I'm just going to hold the camera here.
Now please look in the mirror. And the mirror is a reflection on yourself and the past and the year that went by. So you're kind of going to reflect. Because, as you can see on the table, this represents Manashni, Gavashni, Kunashni.
What does Manashni, Gavashni, Kunashni mean for people who are not Zarathustri?
So basically, the Zoroastrian religion is about, totally about good thoughts, good words and good deeds. And it is an ecological religion. It believes totally in spreading reverence on maintaining the earth and the planet and all its various biodiverse forms. And this is a celebration of spring when everything blooms again, and it's showing abundance. Nature is so abundant, all it needs is us to look after it.
And so your Navroz table is really a representation of that.
Yes, it's really. And it's showing that if you look after the planet is there for you. And that's why the mirror is reflecting on your deeds and your association with the planet, because it's showing you how abundantly the planet is giving.
That's.
So I'll just explain about the table represents half Shin and half Sin. Mm-hmm. And that's different Persian words. All the things on the table which kind of sprout and are there for human beings on earth, they are like in with Shur, and some are with Sir.
Okay.
So I just start with all the Shurs first.
Okay, so you've labeled it.
Yes, we have Sharbat, we put Sharbat on the table, we have Sharab, we have Sheer, and Shahid, which is honey. And we have Shegufe. Shegufe means buds.
Shegufe means buds.
Buds, yes.
Ah, okay.
And then, of course, we have
Sabze.
So we have Sabze is the one with the sir.
Oh.
Yeah, so then we have Shekar and Shama, which is candle. Light is extremely important in our religion because light is the forces of good. So light is an extremely important aspect of the table. Now I'll take you through all the scene, the sir sounds, that which are again represent certain things. There is seer here, which is garlic, representing health. And there's samanu. Now in India, unfortunately, we don't have this traditional samanu, which is actually wheat, kind of something made with wheat. But we again have something called seer here, which we need traditionally.
So you make with seer.
So I made a Parsi kind of dish with the same two Parsi dishes, again made with wheat.
Yeah.
Semanu is a sweet pudding.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have Somak. Unfortunately, I was not able to get these berries, but they represent sunrise, they are bright yellow in color.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have Serke, that's vinegar. Shows patience and maturity.
Okay.
Then we have Seeb, which is apple.
Apple.
Representing good health.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have Seke, which represents prosperity. So various coins, of course, any kind of coins will do. Somebody gave me this on the anniversary.
Okay.
And then we have, of course, we sprout wheat about 10 days before, again representing spring and new life. It just gives a lot of positivity to our health, that whenever there's a down, you have an up again. Just mm-hmm. like you have winter, there's always spring again. Rejuvenation of life and bringing back things to life. Again, representing the rejuvenation factor is are these eggs.
Painted eggs.
Painted eggs, yes. There are different ways they paint it in Persia. For example, sometimes they just tie old pieces of cloth and they boil it and you get various colors in the days before paint.
Yeah.
But I am vegan, so I use this year after year. I don't, kind
Fair
of...
Fair enough.
So I use these like for posterity, they just
Fair
come
enough.
Back on the table.
Now,
then there's of course there is a kind of Persian olive. Now I didn't get a Persian olive here,
mm-hmm.
which is like they are kind of berries, so it's sanjay.
Okay.
So I've just put some other berries.
These are like barberries almost.
Yes. So actually, we are farmers. We grow chikus, so
mm-hmm.
it's and of course jamuns. And one of the things we do is whatever we grow on the farm, we offer it again.
On the table.
On the table. So we do find more of the fruits which we grow. For example, we have these water apples, red water apples, and or jamuns, and we have chikus here. And so those are some of the
fruits that you put.
That we also put.
And what are these sweets
and
that you have?
We, these are some of the Iranian sweets.
Mm-hmm.
And luckily, there is a gentleman in Mumbai who makes it. It's Irani, it's called Iranian sweet
panis.
So was able to get. Another very important thing is the first thing we put on the table is the Avesta. I've managed to get a small
one.
Prayer book in Persian and this is in Gujarati. And we put this Iranian scarf also on the table.
Mm-hmm.
And another thing that we do also keep on the table if we have is the Shahnama.
Ah, yes, the Shahnama.
Shahnama also, some people put it.
So that's lovely.
And of course, here, as you can see, I've opened the Shahnama. It's writing about how Jamshedji Nowruz first started by King Jamshed.
Lovely.
And how it brought prosperity.
Okay, so I noticed this beautiful bowl with some very different, some familiar but some different looking fruit, dry fruits. Can you just talk me through this, please?
Yeah, so actually I have friends and relatives and I always request them when they come from Iran, could you bring me some of the things I can put on my Nowruz table? And of course I store them for years on end. So these are mulberries, again with a shatut. Shatut, yeah, mulberries. These pine nuts, these are dates, and these are walnuts. And this is something we used to love in our childhood called Noglok.
Noglok, yes. Okay.
And
is it sweet?
Yes, it's a sweet. It's the sweet of Iran. Like it's a
Noglok.
Like the equivalent of, say, a toffee or sweet. And an apricot. So these, but anyone celebrating Nowruz, of course, they do not have to go into such detail and trouble people. But it's just that because I keep storing it for posterity in my refrigerator and I use it once a year.
But you could put, if you were laying a table, you could put any fruit or nut.
Yeah, this is just a packet from India.
Mm-hmm.
And when guests come and they actually, it's a time when guests and relatives, friends, neighbors come to our place and this is how we greet them. And that is why we put this out, and that is how they take, they, of course they eat it, they taste it, they take, can take some home.
I know, I've taken many home every time I come to visit. So yeah. Tell me, Katie, I know a lot of Parsis also lay a lovely Navroz table, and people celebrate all over the world. Apart from the seven shirs and the seven sirs, can you personalize the table, or can you tweak things if you don't have it?
Yes, I mean, you can, the sky is the limit. You know, you can be creative. You can put anything as long as there's a little. You can, I mean, you don't have to follow exactly this kind of the layout, sorry, for the table. You just can put some fruits and dry fruits very in a very simple way. And of course, any Indian mithai would do. It's just that I wanted it to be, you know, slightly more
authentic.
Like one of some of my childhood these memories and that kind of thing. So I took, you know, took special efforts too. And I put a little angel here. So this is, of course, my very own kind of tweaking.
Your addition to
it. My addition. One of my friends got it from Iceland. And so it's, I always look to the angel also and hope it guides me. So these are the little things.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, and Navroz Mubarak to you. Thank you for doing this for me. It's very, very sweet.
It was a pleasure. I'm so happy you could record it. Because one of the things the kids love to do the morning after Navroz is they come this little bowl of sugar, and there's a little bowl of salt. And of course we leave it open in the night, and the kids come and they see the fairies have put a little pinch, and I've actually seen it through my childhood. My fingers are crossed that tomorrow there will be a little pinch over here.
A little pinch,
pinch
from
on the salt. There will be like a little pinch, like mark on the salt and the
and
sugar.
What does that signify?
That signifies that the fairies have come and they have
blessed the house.
They have blessed and they have relished and appreciated
beautiful. Thank you so much for doing this. Navroz Mubarak. I'm gonna come back at night and do everything again. Thank you so much. For Parsi New Year, I put up a video on the difference between the Parsis and the Iranis. I just think that's a great video for you to watch so you can understand about my community and my religion a little bit more. So I'll link that down below as well and hope you enjoy that. So that was really it. This is my little tribute to Navroz. Hope you enjoyed it. If you do, as always, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to the channel. I want to do more videos like this. I want to give you more insight into what I'm doing, what I'm cooking, about my community, things that I do, where I travel, a whole bunch of things. So it'll just be a great way to stay connected and get updated on all my new videos. So I'll see you guys.